Hey golf people, on this video we are battling the Cobra Radspeed versus the brand new LTDx LS model. We're gonna find out all the similarities and differences of these two drivers as we go on course, out on the range, and in studio. Let's do it.
We're gonna compare these two drivers here today. And a lot of people asked me on last video, why did I choose the LS model of the LTDx? Well, one of the reasons is because it's very similar in terms of being a low spin driver and the ball flight characteristics of the Radspeed, which was last year's driver. And I wanted to do this video so we could compare and contrast a low spinning driver from Cobra. Now let's take a look at the actual measurements of these two and see where they are similar and where they're different. So first we're gonna go ahead and put the head of the LTDx LS on there. You can see it's 193.3 grams. Switching to the Radspeed here, 195.7 grams, so just a tiny bit heavier there. Now, if we get out the calipers, with the Radspeed, I've got a face height of 54.6 millimeters. If we switch over to the LTDx, it's a little bit less, 52.8. Corner to corner here, I've got 110.9 millimeters. With the LTDx and with the Radspeed, which has this awesome infinity face as well, maybe just a little bit longer at 112.3 millimeters.
So I went to the range and I found that the spin numbers on these were very similar. However, distance was longer with the LTDx LS, and I found that was most likely due to a higher apex height, as you can see here. Apart from that, everything else looked very similar from the numbers. So let's go ahead and take these two out on course and see who wins out. Guys, it's time to take these both out on course here and see who comes out on top. I've got two sets of balls. One is marked green for the Radspeed. The others have no markings on them for the LTDx. Let's see what happens here. First up is the Radspeed. Nice trajectory, very tight draw there. Looks like it'll be right side of the fairway. Club speed 95. Ball speed 138, smash factor 1.45, and I thought I hit that low on the face. That's a good ball there. Man, that felt good. Club speed 99, ball speed 140, smash factor 1.41, estimated carry 218 with the roll 235. All right, I'm switching over to the LTDx now.
I don't think that Radspeed could be beat, honestly. Maybe that one did. Very similar to line to the first one. Club speed 96, smash factor 1.44, ball speed 139, estimated carry 216. Ooh, wow. Same trajectory as the second one, basically. Club speed 95, so less than the rad speed on the second one. Smash factor 1.47 though, ball speed 140, estimated carry 219, carry and roll 237.
Let's go find out where these things ended up. I'm super curious. Guys, I gotta say, I forgot how forgiving that Radspeed driver is. Really liked the way it felt. But what's incredible is on shots that were a little bit lower on the face, because I hit two shots lower on the face there and two right in the middle, I'd say the LTDx felt better, and it almost, I know it's crazy to say, it felt like it was correcting that miss hit. And I think maybe that has to do with that variable thickness that Cobra's talking about. As good as the Radspeed was, both really great on miss hits, I think the LTDx got it, but we gotta see. Now I think this is gonna be a really good test of these drivers, because the first two balls of each were a little low on the face and a little on the right-hand side of the fairway. The second two balls were both right in the middle, and swing speed was a little better with the Radspeed, another 4 mile an hour it looked like. So be interesting to see where these things end up. And these are some good shots. Two of them are right here in front of me, and two of them are over there to the left. I don't know which is which. I really couldn't tell you, honestly. In the air, into this fog, it looked very similar. I'll tell you what, I'll take any four of these drives no matter what. Here we go. First one of the day is not my ball. Okay, someone else's ball, apparently. I guess there's a couple up here a little further. Happens. I guess someone just said screw it on 18 maybe yesterday. Here we go. All right, first ball here at 235. That's a little better. That's an LTDx, folks, at 234. up here looks like it's gonna be our rad speed actually. It's got the green. It's got the green dot at 246. Wow, that's not what I was gonna guess there, I'll say that. Let's go check the other side of the fairway. All right, now on the other side of the fairway, we got one ball here and one ball here. Here we go. That's a rad speed at 251. Still a great drive looking down at the hole. But wow, this one is big, guys. Look at this. I don't think you see me pass that water if you watch this show very often, especially in the first hole. But look at that. 265 with what, 4 mile an hour less swing speed? I've got a little wedge shot in there. And I'll tell you what, I might just hit it because I've never been there ever. Wow. This hole, usually playing into the wind. The wind's down definitely today. There's not much wind. But I've definitely never been here before. Maybe once with the Sim 2, maybe. Guys, I gotta say, I think that's about a tie because I think the Radspeed did a little bit better over here on the right-hand side, irking out a little bit more distance on the same line with the shot that was a little lower on the face. The two we caught in the middle, that was considerably better here with the LTDX. We gotta go to number two here, right after I hit this wedge shot, guys. I'm sorry, you'll have to indulge me, but I gotta hit this one. Thanks for indulging me, guys. Let's go to test number two. All right, next test here. We're gonna go LTDX first. We've got a par four, actually a little dog leg right, but it's pretty flat. It should give us a really good test. Mm. Wow. Gosh, it feels good. Mm. Same line, kind of at that bunker. Let's move on to the rad speed here. Hit well. That's nice and high. That's right down the middle. There we go. Similar line to both the LTD and LTDX. Well, guys, I feel like I'm hitting the rad speed better than I hit it last year even. Man, I'm really impressed with what I'm seeing in terms of trajectory all of a sudden. Last year, I felt like I was hitting it a little bit low and it was running and it was very forgiving, but I feel like I'm getting the distance out of it this time. I'm really excited to see where these balls are. Here's one thing I will say. I feel like so far after a few tests here that the rad speed is going to be a little bit better in terms of dispersion. And if you're looking for the distance, the LTDX may be the way to go. That's my early thoughts. We'll see what these balls did. Whew, there's some good ones out there. Guys, we got some good balls here. We've got one here, one up there, right here, and then one near the bunker. This is gonna be very interesting, guys. This is an LTDX 239, dead center of the fairway, but those two are definitely better. Let's see what they are. This is a good ball, man. This is a Radspeed 255. Very nice, perfect shot. Absolute perfect angle at this hole. Sorry for the mower. Guy's mowing his lawn over here. That's what happens when it's real life, guys. This is not staged. 253 rad speed. Just so you see the green dot. Wow. 255 and 253 in the fairway. One over here just tugged it a little bit left. A little bit left. 257. A little bit left, still a great angle at the pin on this hole. That's what I'm saying, guys. This is what I'm seeing. I'm seeing more distance with the LTDX, a little bit better dispersion with the rad speed. On this hole, I gotta give it to the rad speed though. Let's go to test number three. Guys, if you like either of the drivers that I'm hitting today, the place to buy them is our friends playbetter.com, who stock Cobra clubs. They've got really fast shipping, 48 hours in the continental United States. It's the best price you're gonna find anywhere. These guys are super competitive, and they also treat the Let's Play Thru fans like VIPs that you are. And they're just super nice guys who love golf. playbetter.com, get your Cobra driver there, and help support this show. All right, now we're walking over to a hole that is very loud. Not only do we have the mower behind us, we've got the street to the left of us. So my apologies for the sound quality, but again, I'm not in a studio. I'm not in a simulator room. I'm out here in the world with you. This is real life.
Oh, that's a perfect trajectory. Little left. I'll tell you what, it straightened right out. So it ended up being on the same path.
Both of those balls in the perfect spot in this hole. I liked what I saw there with the Cobra because it was a miss hit and it just ever so slightly course corrected. Hopefully you see that on the shot tracker.
LTDX coming.
Well, guys, that's about as good as I can hit golf balls. Man, either of these drivers are really good. I'd hate to even choose between them. I think it's very clear that the smash factor is way up on the LTDX. Absolutely. I think it's very clear to see that even if the club speed isn't as high, and it wasn't there, the smash factor and therefore ball speed leaving the club is up with the LTDX. No doubt about it, and you can see it. I can see it visually out here. You might not be able to see through the fog. Luckily, we've got the shot tracer, but I can see it. And it's very impressive. All of these drives I would take. Let's see where they ended up. Whoa, right here, there's two that are maybe 30 yards different. That's actually very surprising that they're this far off. Okay, here we go. First ball here. That's a rad speed at 215. Honestly, don't know what happened there. I know that's the one I hit that sort of course corrected, but I'm kind of surprised that the distance was down that much, honestly. That's surprising. All right, there's one right up ahead of it, which I've got to think is the LTDX. Actually, there's two up there, and there's one over here to the right. Let me get the one to the right here first. This is just, man, guys, you tell me in the comments, is this fairway or is this rough? It's really hard to say. The rough is a little cut low. I guess that's rough. At 236, that right there, folks, is an LTDX at 237. Great angle at the hole here, though. I want to call that a fairway in regulation so bad, but I guess we'll call it rough. You tell me in the comments. Now, we've got the two best ones I hit here. These are the two best ones. I could feel it right off the club. 246, that's rad speed. 247 now. 247, dead center. Beautiful drive. Off a little bit to the left here, but once again a little further. At 251, that's the LTDX. There you have it, guys. Those two balls were as good as I can hit golf balls on this hole today. And they were both very well hit. And I think we can tell you pretty definitively now that if you are looking for distance, the LTDX is the way to go. And if you are looking for a little bit more control, a little bit more forgiveness, want to find a few more fairways, the Rad Speed is going to be the club for you. What do you guys think down below in the comments? I mean, I think I could be hitting drivers here all day and we'd see the same thing, because this is what I saw on the range and this is what I'm seeing out on course. Let me know if you've had a chance to test down either of these drivers. I'd be very curious to see your results, but I have a sneaky suspicion they'll be the same. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this one. I enjoyed being with you immensely. Once again, could use your subscribe if you haven't subscribed to this channel. And we've got March Madness coming. The LTDX is going to be pitted up against the top seven other drivers of 2022, the best of the best, in a March Madness style bracket. Only on Let's Play Thru, you will see all seven head-to-head matches, and we will crown a champion at the end. So get subscribed to this channel now, and I'll catch you back here very soon. Race car. Race car ruined my outro. I'll catch you back here very soon on another edition of Let's Play Thru. Peace.